श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 6 चैप्टर 12 टेक्स्ट 19 इंद्रवाच And you know, physically I am unable to do, mentally there will be fighting in the mind, all bad thoughts will be coming over. But here you see Dhritarashtra's case. Dhritarashtra is so full of Krishna consciousness that he is encouraging Indra that you kill me because that's the will of providence. I have been born as your enemy, that is will of providence. And I am supposed to be killed by you, that is also decided by the law. So why are you hesitating? Indra and Kirti was hesitating and gave up his sentence and he did not want to fight anymore. But Dhritarashtra is telling it's all decided, it's all the will of the Lord appeared, he has blessed you. He has told to make a weapon using the Rijisvara bones, and that is a suitable weapon to kill me. That's the will of the Lord, so let the will of the Lord be executed and let me be killed by you. So this is the mati, this is the determination and discrimination of a devotee. For the sake of pleasing the Lord, he is ready to take up any sort of pain. First of all, the devotee never identifies himself with the body. Here you can see Dhritarashtra's case, even though he has fallen down and his arms are cut off, so much pain would be there, isn't it, in the body. But still his consciousness is separated from the body. His consciousness is not identifying himself with the body. He is aloof, even though he is there in the body, he is not disturbed by the bodily condition. There was an example given in Lord Chaitanya's Leela. There was one devotee, Vasudeva. He also had wounds throughout his body and burns were eating the wounds. So, somehow, when Lord Chaitanya was traveling in South India, he goes to the Kshetra, Kurma Kshetra, where he meets Kurma Brahmana. That Brahmana also is a pure devotee. In that place only this Vasudeva also was residing. So one night the Lord stays there in Kurma Brahmana's house and then the next day he just leaves. And then Vasudeva comes there to the Kurma Brahmana's house and asks, where is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? I wanted to have darshan of him. Then the Brahmana says that he has left already. And hearing this news, he will faint immediately. He was so devoted. And then looking at his devotion, the Lord wherever he had gone immediately appeared there. He has so much devotion, so much eagerness to see me, and the Lord will embrace him. And then Vasudeva told, my dear Lord, why did you embrace me? When the Lord embraces him, all that leprosy and the wounds, whatever was there on the body disappears immediately. And he becomes very beautiful. The body becomes so beautiful, handsome. So he will lament, my dear Lord, why did you do this? Now I will become proud that I have such a beautiful body. And it's a disturbance for me. So a devotee is always afraid of material opulence, beauty. Because he knows these are all dangerous objects. They are all obstacles in devotion. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim, kavitam, va jagadisha kamayim. My dear Lord, I don't want wealth, material wealth, neither I need followers, na janam, na sundarim, neither I require a good, beautiful wife. So, this is a devotee. A devotee is detached from material objects, detached from material objects, including his own personal body. He doesn't utilize his body for its sense gratification. But at the same time, knowing that his body belongs to the Lord, he maintains it for serving the Lord. It's called Yukta Vairagya. He doesn't reject his body as useless. He maintains it for the purpose of using it in the service of the Lord. So here is explained how a devotee who is fixed in Krishna consciousness is not disturbed even in greatest danger. So that verse is there in Bhagavad Gita. Yam labdhva chaparam labham manyate na adhika his connection with the Supreme Lord, his relationship with the Supreme Lord, has realized his self, he has realized the Supreme Lord. That's a lava, that's a gain, topmost gain one can achieve. In that situation, yasmin sthitaha na dukhena gurunapi vicharyate. In that situation, even though it's the greatest danger, ordinarily in material estimation, but a devotee is not disturbed, even in the greatest danger. So this is the symptom of a devotee. So the Dhritarashtra was in greatest danger, he was about to die, he was about to be killed by Indra, but still he was not at all disturbed. You can see how he is fixed in consciousness. This is self-realization. This is Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is going to make us fearless. So that is explained in one more place in Bhagavatam. It is explained, Jnana Vairagya Yuktena Bhakti Yogena Yogina. These Bhakti Yogis, they are Jnana Vairagya Yuktena. Because they have complete knowledge that I am not this body, I am different from the body, I am so Upala Krishna. And Vairagya Yuktena, Jnana Yuktena, Vairagya Yuktena, both. When there is Jnana, automatically there is Vairagya also. Detachment from something which is not me. Just like Krishna gives example, just like this body is compared to a dress. Vasansi Tirnani Yatha Vihaya. When the dress is Tirnani, when the dress becomes worn out and it tears, Vihaya, you just reject it. You don't put on bother about it. Isn't it? Who will worry about it? Oh, my dress. For 10 years I was wearing. Now it is gone. Will anyone cry? You'll just reject it and take a new dress. Vasansi Tirnani Yatha Vihaya. One will be happy to have a new dress, isn't it? Tatha sharirani vihaya jirnani anyani samyati navani de. Similarly, when the body becomes useless, old and truly diseased and not able to stay in this, he'll just reject it and enter the new body. So devotee is completely realized. He is not that, it's not just theoretical. Initially for a sadhaka it's theory. Krishna is giving us this knowledge that we are not the body also. Now we have to realize it. We have to actually feel that. Just like now we feel because it's external, easily we can make out. This dress is dead matter, whatever you do, you know, it doesn't affect me. It's very clear for us. Isn't it? You cut it and it's not paining for me. Now our consciousness is so much, you know, mixed up with the material body. That element which connects the soul and body is the false ego. So we are so much overwhelmed by false ego that bodily suffering we identify as my suffering. But if you see in the examples of selfless soul, they are not having, you kill me, come on, why are you not killing me? Vasudeva is picking up all the worms and putting, worms will be biting, so much pain will be there, isn't it? And he is putting, that means how much is separated out from the body? That is possible only when we are bhakti yuktena kshemaya padamulam me pravishanti akuto bhayam. The Lord is telling that when you take kshemaya padamulam me, take the shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, only then it is possible, pravishanti, only then it is possible to enter into the kingdom of God. So taking shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord means taking shelter of His pure devotee. Initially, we cannot directly enter into the kingdom of God. We have to go through His pure devotee. So taking shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord means surrendering to a devotee. Surrendering to a pure devotee means following his instructions. So to practice bhakti is a given nectar of instruction. What enhances devotion? It's
Working and
because now we are in modeling platform. We are not like now the transfer generator, so already generated. We are not in that platform. We are in body of platform. So Krishna is teaching us from body to platform how you can elevate. First of all, be regulated in your ahara. Eat in time, moderate quantity. And sleep in time. The sleep is so important because it is one of the characteristics of intelligence. There are five characteristics: doubting, doubtfulness, misapprehension, then apprehension, sleep, none more. This is explained in Bhagavatam. If you don't have sufficient sleep, then your intelligence will not work properly. The whole day will go waste, dullness, and you cannot think properly. So right quantity of sleep has to be given for proper functioning of this body. This yantra is created by the Lord and it has its own way of maintenance. If we interfere with the laws of nature, then we are only going to suffer. So we have to have regulated sleep. Early to bed and early to rise, that's the program. We have to go to bed early, rise early. Once or twice we can say, okay, there was festival, so we could not sleep early. That is all right. For the sake of a lot of extra sacrifice we are doing. But it cannot go on a regular basis every day. Every day sleeping late. And then again there is a force. You have to rise early, you cannot rise early. Even if you rise here for the sake of, you know, because of fear. You should be fearless actually. Because of fear, someone will question me. Temple commander will come and ask, why you are not getting up? So I have no reason, so just get up. The body only is here in the temple hall. Mind is somewhere else. So this will not help in devotion. Because ultimately for whose benefit we are doing devotion? Benefit. It is for our own benefit. It is not for someone else's benefit. If I attend Arati nicely, if I chant nicely, I am only going to get liberated. For my benefit, other devotees are trying to help me, that's all. So, we have to follow Krishna's instructions as our best friend, and devotion begins with regulation on the bodily platform. Ahara Nidra. And then work also. Guru Maharaj has given us so much service to do. Now we cannot go and conquer the whole world because we are not yet ready. We also are struggling. So many problems. Systematic way. First, we should get trained. We should become strong. We have to become purified. Proportionately, Krishna will open up doors for us to go and preach. Prabhupada said, in 18 days we can conquer the whole world. And you are all not ready to handle it. Suppose the whole world is given to us. So many thousands of people come and stand here, near Bandila, in Bandila, you know, this problem, that problem. Then what will you tell them? Our world is in your hand. Suppose Krishna gives tomorrow. All posts, Prime Minister, Water Minister, every ministership, one and devotee. What do you do? You cannot handle their problems. Isn't it? First of all, we have to become pure devotees. Then we'll have such firm conviction in bhakti that just by desiring, those problems will get solved actually. Just by desiring. So we have to first of all practice devotion as recommended by Lord Krishna and as recommended by Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada also very strict. And then you can see in Prabhupada's life also, whenever it was required, he would take all steps to preach. Once on the stand went to Prabhupada, throughout the day Prabhupada was engaged in so many things, preaching. And finally at 9:30 he goes to his room to relax and take rest. At that time President goes, Prabhupada, sorry to disturb you now. Actually, with great difficulty, we got the permission for one TV interview. they were created. And Prabhupada says, so how many people watch this? He says, millions of people. All right, let us go. So Prabhupada agrees. Then president says, Prabhupada, actually it's not now. The show is at midnight, 1 o'clock. Prabhupada says, doesn't matter, come on, let us go. And they go to the studio. And then it's a show where the anchor asks some questions and the invitee has to answer. So the anchor starts asking about Krishna consciousness, about God and all that. Prabhupada with such enthusiasm, he starts answering that even the anchor's heart starts melting by hearing Prabhupada's reply. Anchor should be a neutral person just asking questions on behalf of the audience and running the show. But every answer Prabhupada gives, his anchor becomes so melted that at one point of time, he will say, my dear Swamiji, will you bless me? Please. These are all personal things actually. Millions of people are watching. So you can see Prabhupada is not just preaching to as a part of, as an official preaching. He is actually touching the heart, touching every soul he meets. He doesn't see a reporter as a reporter. He sees that this is a soul sent by Krishna to me. And it's my duty to present Krishna to him. Such genuinity is there in a devotee. He genuinely cares for the soul. He is so sincere. Sincerity means he is so genuine. I really want to help you. You are suffering. So that genuineness is needed in a devotee. He has to be really sincere. And it's manifest immediately. If you are genuine, it will manifest in your body, words, and mind, in every action. So that's why Prabhupada says, sincerity and seriousness is the secret of success in Krishna consciousness. You have to be genuine, you have to be sincere in what you are doing. Seriousness means, this is Supreme Lord Jagadishwaran's mission, not some ordinary karmis or organization. It'll go because of karma. Karma is good, it will run nicely. And karma is bad, you have to go away. This is Jagadishwara, Lord Chaitanya's mission. He has inaugurated and gone. And has declared that it is going to increase for next 10,000 years. It is already declared by God. We are not in ordinary medical mission. It is not a medical organization making some profits, medical profits. It is Jagadishwara's organization, and you should be really jumping, bubbling with enthusiasm and jumping with joy that I got admission here, I got some place here, I got some service here to do in the Supreme Lord's organization. What else is there to acquire? Yamlakva chaparam lalam nadikam nanyate nadikam tata. There is nothing more to achieve in life. But if you do not do Svadhyaya, you do not recall these things, you do not discuss about how great achievement I have got already, how great blessing and mercy I have got, immediately you will start neglecting. You will start offending. Negligence is an offense. You don't know the value of staying here and rendering service to the Lord. Because of offenses, Maya will drag us away. So therefore, we have to be serious. So sincerity is required for your personal progress, and you have to teach others. We have to be sincere and we have to practice it seriously. It's not ordinary, you can't take it lightly. Okay, one day I don't go, what will happen? No, you are accountable. Every action you are doing is observed. You are all answerable. You are all dependent living beings. You are not independent. So, we have to take it seriously. Everything I do has to be done seriously. So, sincerity and seriousness. Prabhupada, in Mayapur, when they were constructing, initially when the devotees went, it was all just barren land, paddy field, and open land. There is no facility at all to stay. So, the devotees built some huts to stay, and you know, there is no toilet, there is no water facility. They have to. All that mud is all loose and wet. So full of so much of problems, materialistic problems. And somehow, when we are, they started constructing the first guest house, and they had to pay for the laborers, that also some problems. With all problems, somehow the first guest house construction was going on. And Prabhupada was so happy, even in that condition. Still, that construction is not complete, and some room was given to Prabhupada, and all that noise, the carpenters are beating, and so much noise. Still, Prabhupada, one devotee came, he wanted to close the windows. Because I think too much of storm, so he thought it was all disturbing, and he went to close the windows. And Prabhupada said, he was seeing what he's doing. Then he called Vinanya, open all the windows. Then he opened. He said, even though there's so much disturbance, I'm so happy. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's place. Now I have given you this, you enjoy it and distribute this to people. So Prabhupada was going on now. Prabhupada was so much attached to the Mayapur project. Even getting land was so difficult. Somehow they got the land and they started building. So he went, he was walking through. He saw that in one room, fan was running. And there was no one inside. Prabhupada called, come see who has done this. He said, oh, I don't know Prabhupada. Whoever he is, tell him he's a rascal. Tell him. How he can do like this? He can give the fan and go like this. You tell him he's a rascal. So that is a devotee. A devotee is not at all negligent with what Krishna has blessed. He takes every atom of Krishna's blessing so seriously. Not that, okay, we'll care. Let this get destroyed, no problem. Some new one will buy. No, we cannot be negligent. Krishna's blessings has to be protected, preserved, and has to be used for Krishna's service. So Prabhupada would show by his personal example how we have to maintain Krishna's mission, how careful we have to be, how detached you have to be personally. Prabhupada also gives an example how vairagya means, how it should be. So when he was in America, so he would be, you know, wandering in different places and renting different apartments now and then. He's changing places. So when he took some apartment on rent, those are listening, where is your furniture? Prabhupada said, there is no furniture. So materialistic people means they cannot live without furnitures. If they shift their house, with all their furniture they have to go. Prabhupada says, a devotee is so detached that he just fly on the floor. He doesn't require any furnitures. Even those hippies, those Americans who took up the Krishna consciousness, they were used to all those comforts. When they became Krishna conscious, they would take all austerities in that Mayapur, you know, when their construction is going on. No proper place to stay, and all nasty, and they have to go somewhere for toilet, somewhere. They are ready to take up all austerities, lie down on the floor. This is what is vairagya. Vairagya means, for myself, I don't require any luxury, no comfort. And to preach, I will do it very vigorously. Any type of service you can tell me, and fired up, I will go. So these things are the right values which we have to learn from the spiritual master, and value it. Value very important. We have to be grateful that it is Supreme Lord's mission, and if I do it, whether success or failure is not my consideration. Like here, Rudrasura actually is on time, but he is fixed in his consciousness that it is the will of the Lord that it happen. So like that, we should be fixed in our consciousness, whatever is told to me, till the end I will do it. I will not budge an inch. Let that service get completed, then only I will go on sleep. So that is the determination of a devotee. Till the service allotted, then suppose some service are deadline oriented. Tomorrow is the main, say, Janmashtami festival has come, and Pandavala has not come still. You cannot say, I will not be Yukta Aravya. We have to be there tomorrow festival, and it's my service. Uttara does not mean always will be like that. When there is a situation where you have got some service to be done, you have to stretch yourself for the pleasure of the Lord, you have to take the discomfort. Later on you can go and sleep. When the Shamayana is fully ready, now you can go and lie down in bed. Prabhuji, you can go and see everything is ready. Now you permit me, I will go and take rest. So like that, this is bhakti. Voluntarily accepting inconvenience to the body and mind. That is only purpose. If you do this, then you are successful. So this we learn from Prasada's example, that he is fixed in his consciousness, fixed in his determination, and he acted in the episode in the previous purports. Even though he was an enemy of Indra, he was acting as a spiritual master of Indra. He was giving him, encouraging him, giving him advices. So this is what we have to do. We have to learn from our spiritual master and safeguard that instructions, that parampara message, we cannot get anywhere else. When we receive that instructions, we have to follow it as it is and pass it on to future generation. That is what is our duty. So here we can see, yasmin sthito na dukhena gurunapi na vicharyate. This is a symptom of a Krishna conscious person. Let any dukkha come, I will do it. I will be here, I will practice these instructions. There's nothing more to achieve in life. I've already come to the right place. There's only some time required now to become purified. So patiently, I will follow. So this is how we have to be firmly fixed up in Krishna consciousness. This happens when we regularly do Swadhyaya, when we regularly associate with pure devotees and the Lord in the Palam Bhagavatam, then we are saved. So this is the instruction we get in this verse today. Pushkarandarshana Bhagavatam ki. Yeah.